Good morning, students. Today again we'll take lesson water in class 8 chemistry. And in the last class I explained you about the different properties of water. In that property I told you that water is colorless, tasteless, liquid, and water exists in all the three states: solid, in the form of ice, liquid, water, and gases, water vapor. And one more point I told you about, that water has high specific heat. So first of all, you understand what is specific heat. So specific heat of heat is the heat required by water or any substance to raise the temperature of its unit mass by 1 degree Celsius. So whenever the amount of heat which is required to raise the temperature of a substance by 1 degree Celsius, that heat is called specific heat. And water has high specific heat. In the same way, latent heat means amount of heat required by it to change its state. State means from solid to liquid or liquid to gas. So the amount of heat which is required to change from one state to another in any liquid or any substance, then it is called the latent heat. And water has high specific heat. It requires that it absorbs a large amount of heat to become hot. Conversely, it will need to lose a large amount of heat to become cold. Means water, whenever water becomes hot, then only it will become hot when it will absorb a large amount of heat. So when a large amount of heat is absorbed by the water, it becomes hot, and it also need to lose a large amount of heat to become cold. Means it also needs much time or long time again to become hot as well as cold. So that's why land cools up faster as well as heat up faster, whereas water cools also slowly and heat also slowly, because it absorbs a large amount of heat. Then only a large, when it absorbs a large amount of heat, then only it become hot. And when it needs a large amount of heat to become cold, then only it will become cold. Means it will take long time to become hot and cold for the water. That is the main property of the water. And that's why water is also used as a coolant in factories, in car engines, nuclear reactors. This is this property of water only, that it heats up too long and cools also too long, takes more time. That's why it is used in the coolant in factories, car engines, nuclear reactors and other. Now water, another property of water is that water also shows anomalous behavior. So what is the anomalous behavior? Generally what we see that the volume of substance decreases on cooling. Means whenever we cool any substance, then its volume decreases. But in case of water, it is opposite. What happens in case of water? The volume of water increases or expand when the temperature drops from 4 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius. So generally the volume of substance decreases on cooling, but here the volume of water increases or expand when it drops from 4 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius, and this is only called anomalous behavior of water or abnormal behavior of water. Now another main property, that generally solids have greater density than liquid. You all know that if we throw a piece of nail or stone in the water, the nail or stone sink in the water. But in case of water, ice cubes, what happens? Ice, although it is a solid, but it being lighter, floats on the surface of water. So this is the only property of the ice cube, that although it expands on heating, but due to the anomalous behavior only and its density, its volume of the water increases, that remain the same. When it converts into ice, the volume of the ice cube, they remain the same. That's why the ice cubes, being lighter, they float on the surface of water, whereas the other solid object like ink, nail and stones, they sink in the water. So these are some of the physical properties of water which I explained you. Now we'll take the chemical properties of water. Now you all know that pure water is neutral liquid. Neutral means it is neither acidic nor basic. So that's why it does not have any effect on the litmus paper. Litmus paper, you all know that whenever it is acidic or basic, it converts, it changes its color. But in pure water is a neutral liquid, that's why it has no effect on the litmus paper. Neither it is acidic nor it is basic, it is neutral. Second is when we decompose the water at high temperature, means about 2000 degrees Celsius, and by passing electricity, when the water is heated at high temperature 2000 degrees Celsius and by passing electricity, this water H2O, they decompose into hydrogen and oxygen gases. So this is also the chemical properties of the water. Third chemical property is that whenever the water reacts, whenever the white hot coke, when it is heated with the superheated steam or superheated steam combines with the white hot coke in the presence of high temperature. High temperature means 1270 Kelvin. When it is heated, both the mixture, then it is converted into water gas. What is water gas? It is the mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen. So when this water gas, carbon monoxide and hydrogen, they are formed by whenever the superheated steam is passed with the hot white hot coke at very high temperature, when they are heated both the substance, then they convert into water gas. So this is the reaction of water with the non-metals, and in the next class I will tell you also the reaction of water with some non-metals and other elements also, how they react with different elements.